Good morning. Welcome to the celebration of the Mass for the fourth Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant is Father McSweeney. Today's Mass is offered for all parishioners and benefactors, especially Trudy Meal. Today, we gather as a community to celebrate our faith and the start of Catholic Schools Week. We come to show our gratitude for the gift of Catholic schools and of Catholic education, especially our own St. Augustine School. During this week, students, faculty, staff, parents, grandparents, and the people of our parish will show in many different ways that they are proud of our Catholic school. We ask God to continue to bless St. Augustine School and its students, faculty, and staff. Our Mass can be found on page 61 of today's Missal. We will begin our liturgy by prayerfully singing the processional hymn, Faith of Our Fathers, number 515. That's number 515.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, to prepare ourselves to worthily celebrate the sacred mysteries, we must first call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. May God bless you as you minister the body of Christ to our brothers and sisters who cannot be present here with us. And let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth, who have observed his law. Seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered on the day of the Lord's anger. But I leave as a remnant in your midst, a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord.
Keeps faith forever, secures justice for the oppressed, gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets captives free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord raises up those who were bowed down. The Lord loves the just. The Lord protects strangers. And the widow the Lord sustains, but the way of the wicked he thwarts. The Lord shall reign forever. Hear God, O Zion, through all generations.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise. And God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, us well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that is, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With your
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Grace be Jesus Christ, now and forever. This past Advent, I had the great opportunity to travel with the Knights of the Holy Sepulchre on a pilgrimage to the Holy Land, Bethlehem, Nazareth, Jerusalem, and visiting a lot of the churches in the Holy Land that are run by the Franciscan Order. One of the churches we visited was the Church of the Beatitude, the Beatitudes which Christ gives us in today's Gospel. The church is built, they believe, on the spot that Jesus stood as he proclaimed the new teaching to the people. An amazing thing I learned, we're never too old to learn new things, I suppose, was that the word that Christ used in Aramaic is a lot more meaningful than our translation of blessed be or blessed are. The Aramaic word is ashrei, which is derived from the verb yashar, and it means to get up and walk the path of righteousness till you are righteous. Eventually got translated as become blessed. Blessed are you. But the insight I received was that the word that Christ used is an active verb, not a passive verb. We don't just sit back and be blessed are the poor in spirit because eventually the kingdom will be ours. He said, get up, you poor in spirit. Be righteous in the world, for the kingdom of heaven is yours. Get up, you peacemakers, because you are the children of God. It was an inspiring challenge for us who believe in Christ and seek to follow him and seek to enter into the kingdom of God, to be active about it, to do the things that achieve the righteousness in our lives, to do the things each day that make us blessed, to do those things that make us true followers of Christ in the world. And it's a great understanding of what he meant when he preached to the people the Beatitudes, the fulfillment of the commandments of God to teach us how we are to live in this world. And it's not to be a passive force, it's to be an active force. It's to do good, to go out into the world, to show the light amongst those who still dwell in darkness, to show that love overcomes hate, to show that all the things that Christ taught us recreates us. Because another definition of that verb yashar is to turn away from your old ways and get on the path of righteousness. Christ sums it all up. That's his whole gospel, that he teaches us that we are called to be instruments of love in this world, to be his instruments of peace in this world, and we have to turn away sometimes from our former ways to become blessed. Blessed are those who do the things that Christ asks us to do. This week, we as a nation celebrate Catholic School Week, a reminder to us of how important our faith is, that it has to be instilled within the family, but it also has to be instilled and interwoven with everything we learn. At our Catholic school, we teach the faith not only in religion class, but in every class we teach, not only by what we say, but by what we do, because we are an active force in this world, and we need to know that and to realize that and to act upon that. We need to know that we are responsible, that Christ will judge us by how well we go out into the world and reflect his light to others, teach his truth to others. And as we know historically, at least in Western civilization, that understanding of God is sometimes reflected in our music, as we will see today. It's sometimes reflected in our art, as our students take art in our school. Our faith is reflected in everything we do, and that's something we have to remind ourselves of. This great season of ordinary time, now between Christmas and Lent, constantly reminds us that it's in our everyday lives that we carry the message of Christ and are responsible to be witnesses of his truth in this world. Because the world constantly tries to hide in the shadows, they try to find their path in the darkness, and sometimes we are the only instruments of the truth of Christ to bring them out of that if they choose to turn around and become blessed. And Christ tells us all those things that we must be in this world, the poor in spirit. We must be the peacemakers. We must be all of the things that will change the world to more reflect the kingdom that we sometimes, at some time, will await, the kingdom of God. For this world, as we know, will one day pass away, and we were created for a kingdom that is eternal. So as we remember Christ preaching to the multitudes, as we have some new insight into the Beatitudes, we recognize the fact that he calls us to be active in the world, not to sit back and just take our faith for granted, but to know that we are to be a force in this world, a force for good, a force for love, a force for peace. And since it is Catholic Schools Week, I would like to thank the administration of our school who is here, the teachers of our school who are here, the students, and the parents who sacrificed to send their students to our school, because we are a force for good in this world. We teach our children what it means to be honest and virtuous. We teach them what it means to be a true follower of Christ in a world that constantly challenges those virtues, that constantly sows lies in the guise of truth, and that we must always stand firm in knowing that Christ from the very beginning called us to be active witnesses of his truth in this world, and to always know it's in our everyday lives that we bring an extraordinary message. And now let us stand and profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. As we seek to walk by the narrow road towards the kingdom of God, we now offer our prayers to the Father.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Archbishop Timothy Dolan, and all of our church leaders, may they find constant strength and be inspired by the loving example of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father McSweeney, Father Figueroa, Father Matthew, Father Sinante, and our deacons, may they continue to inspire and enrich the young minds and souls entrusted to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sister Mary Elizabeth, Mrs. Fessman, and the faculty and staff of St. Augustine School, may they always follow Jesus' example as teacher and help us to face the academic, social, and moral challenges in our world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our school community during the celebration of Catholic Schools Week, may we always be grateful for the gift of a Catholic education and use our experiences to serve others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parents and families of the school and parish, May we come to know how much God loves and cares for us through them. Continue to bless our families and keep them close in your care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, suffering, or in any kind of danger, may they experience the healing power of Christ's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially those for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our country and our world, may God grant us grace and harmony, leading to an end to fighting and division. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions in our book of petitions and for any intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we beg you to hear and answer our petitions, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory hymn is Give Me Ears to Listen, number 655 in today's Missal, number 655.
Please stand and pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice.
O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them, as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Of
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ, can be saved for everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Our bell choir will play Nimrod, followed by our children's choir and guest cellist performing Jesus, My Lord, My God, My All, number 671 in today's missal. That's number 671.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Just a few notifications. Thank you to our bell choir for assisting us at Mass and for our youth choir. And for our cellist, one of our young men who played last night as well. Thank you, Oliver. We're having an open house in the school for anybody who wants to see all the good work we do in there. Thank you to Sister Mary Elizabeth and Mrs. Fessman for organizing this day and for the staff and faculty of St. Augustine's School who continue to instill the faith in our children so that the next generation will still have the light of Christ. And let us pray. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bestow your grace upon all gathered here today through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
God bless you, Mom.
St. Michael, the Archangel.
St. Augustine's School will be holding an open house right after this Mass. You are all welcome to come. We will close our liturgy by prayerfully singing the hymn to St. Augustine.